the majority of American voters actually do want Republicans to take control of Congress. So a new poll shows that the majority of Americans actually want the GOP to take control of Congress after the 2022 midterm elections. Now, this is typically what happens. It's usually a response to whatever party wins in the general election. Usually by the time the midterms roll around, the opposite party will take control. But Quinnipiac finds that there's already a majority of voters who want Republicans to take control. 46%, in fact, 46% of registered voters say they would rather see Republicans win the House majority in 2022 compared to 41% who say that Democrats should retain control in the lower chamber. So we're talking about the House of Representatives here, but there are pretty bad numbers for Democrats when you look at the Senate specifically. It's a similar case in the Senate. 46% say that the GOP, or they want the GOP to take control of the upper chamber, while 42% are hoping for a Democratic majority. Now, I just want everyone to keep in mind that it isn't going to take much for the GOP to take control of both the House and the Senate. For instance, they need just 5 seats in the House and only 1 seat in the Senate. And considering some of the fumbles we've seen from the Democratic Party, especially in regard to the budget reconciliation bill and passing some of the bread and butter issues that Biden had campaigned on, these results don't really surprise me. But there are some conflicting pieces of data in this Quinnipiac poll, which I'll get to in just a second.
Okay, so there are a number of people at fault here for this outcome. And so I say at fault, one, because the Republican Party is an absolute disaster and will break this country. And so this is a bad outcome for everyone. But second of all, not because I think so, but because the polling indicates that that the American people do not agree with the Republicans at all on almost any issue. Okay, but as usual, the Democratic Party is the most incompetent, buffoonish, ridiculous, inefficient, negligent party we've ever seen. And of course, the corporate media is, as always, horrific. So, Anna, it's actually a little bit worse than the polling indicates because of gerrymandering. So about a third of the states have been gerrymandered already. The Democrats can stop this at the national level, but they won't because they want to protect the filibuster so they can protect their corporate donors on economic issues. And so that has already picked up 5 seats for the Republicans if normal voting holds. And it won't be close elections because the districts are made to be perfectly safe. So they haven't even gone through most of the states. And in the next election, the Republicans will almost definitely pick up 5 seats to win the House. And that's before these terrible polling numbers. And so if the American people actually knew what the Republicans stood for, would they get some percentage of the vote? Yeah, they'd get 30-40%. That's the portion of Americans who think, yay, racism and horrific and, oh, take away my health care, lower my wages just as long as you hate brown people. I get it. I think it's about 30% of the country, right? But overall, most of the country does not agree to that at all, including some portion of Republican voters and almost no independent voters. And Democrats would win easily, but they suck at messaging. But more importantly, it's because they never do anything they promised. So if they'd done the things they promised, you wouldn't have these poll results.
Yeah, for me, I think that this is really a mix of the lack of substantive economic reform coming from the Democratic Party. Also, lack of any real reform when it comes to some of the social issues that they really lean into while they're campaigning, right? And it just becomes more and more clear to various groups of people, whether we're talking about African-Americans, whether we're talking about women, whatever the issue is, there's a lot of messaging in regard to the Democratic Party wanting to pass reforms to better these people's lives. But then once they're in power, all you see is theater and they drop any effort to actually pass legislation. Police reform is a good example of that. So the ineffectiveness of the Democrats, the weakness of Democrats, I think plays a huge role. But you're also right in the fact that the media really doesn't do them many favors either, especially when it comes to the economic reforms that I think would help the Democrats gain a little bit of popularity. But there's something that really stood out to me in this poll that I wanted to get into, because when I talk about conflicting data, I'm specifically referring to the fact that when you look at how American voters feel about the overall effectiveness of Democrats versus Republicans, they seem to favor Democrats a little more. So 31% of Americans say that they approve of the job Democrats in Congress are doing. Let me just note, 31% of Americans is not a high number. However, only 25% say the same about congressional Republicans. So, you know, lower number for Republican legislators, higher number for Democratic legislators. But for me, the big takeaway is not only the conflict in messaging here from the respondents, but also the fact that whether we're talking about Democrats or Republicans, they can't even crack 50%, right? Like their numbers are so low. And it's because I think at this point, voters understand, they know, they've been through enough election cycles to understand that neither party is really working for their best interests.
Yeah. So look, I'll give you two examples of Democratic ineffectiveness that affects this number and will affect the 2022 elections. Number one, the gerrymandering I just told you about, they could end it overnight if they do the For the People Act, if they pass it, that prohibits gerrymandering all across the country. But yes, every Republican is opposed to it because they love gerrymandering. They love rigging elections in their own favor. I'm going to give you an example in a second. But the Democrats are not united. So the Democrats, some Democrats agree with Republicans. We should cheat in favor of Republicans. So they're not going to get rid of the filibuster. So they are not going to pass voting rights that they need for their own survival. You cannot be any more ineffective. You cannot be any more negligent as a party. And you cannot be any more corrupt other than if you're the Republicans. The Republicans tie them on corruption at least. Okay, so then number two, well, theoretically, Biden, Pelosi, Schumer, they all ran on lower drug prices. Now, they're liars. They never meant it. We told you ahead of time, they're never going to pass that. That's just for marketing reasons. And then the corporate media will say, Biden is for lower drug prices. Is he? He hasn't passed at all. 88% of Americans want lower drug prices, that provision. So if you wanted to fight for it, you could easily fight for it. And even if you don't win, the Democrats could make a giant issue out of Republicans want higher drug prices, which is true. Every single Republican in Congress wants higher drug prices. They're against that provision because they're all corrupt. That's the one thing that they beat Democrats on. They're slightly more corrupt. So are the Democrats going to do that for messaging purposes and for policy reasons? No, because they also take money from drug companies. And so their corruption completely disables them from being a functioning party in this country.
Exactly.
I could show you a dozen polls that are massively in favor of Democrats. But unfortunately, the Democrats don't do any of those things that they claim they're going to do. So, all right, I'm promising.
Right, real quick. So it's not that they're massively in favor of Democrats. It's that the voters are massively in favor of policies that are proposed by Democrats, but they're also the same policies that Democrats don't really fight for and abandon immediately. And to your point, Cenk, about how they never carry out these policies, that's the reason why we see Democratic lawmakers, whether it be on a federal level or a local level, like with Terry McAuliffe, leaning into whatever culture war is being manufactured by the right wing at any given time. So the right wing gets to frame the culture war, the culture war du jour, and Democrats are like, let's go for it. Like, let's respond. And Democrats are not going to win the culture war. Because when you're up against fear-mongering, when you're up against people who really offer up one thing and one thing only to voters, which is, you know, you're in a bad spot, but at least you're better than the others, well, then they're going to win. Democrats need to materially benefit people's lives. That's the only winning strategy. And with corporate corruption, they're never going to do it.
Yeah. And so I want to give you the example, one last example of incompetence. But to Anna's point, though, real quick. Yeah, later in the show, we're going to talk about Bill Maher. He goes on there and totally supports right-wing framing of racial issues. And Chris Cuomo loves it, and they high-five over it, and then Cuomo tells him how brave he is for supporting right-wing ideology. It's absurd. It's absurd. It's absurd. So the media is never, like, they cheerlead for corporate Democrats or Republicans. They don't really care. As long as they're corporate and bipartisan and moderate, and why do they all switch and are now piling onto the Democrats now, because this was the point where they were going to try to pass a bill that had higher corporate taxes. Oh, no, that's it. Now, everyone in mainstream media all of a sudden hates the Democrats, hates Biden, hates Kamala Harris, when before they were kissing their ass. So they got rid of the anti-establishment Trump. They bring in establishment Biden, and then they neuter him so he can't do anything. This is such classic American politics. So the example I was going to give about the gerrymandering is in North Carolina, it's a 1.5-point split. So it's nearly tied in North Carolina when you look at the state voting. Because of the gerrymandering, Republicans are going to have 10 districts and the Democrats are going to only have 4. 10 to 4 when they're nearly tied. And the Democrats go, okay, yeah, sure, do it. We're not going to do anything to stop you. Even though it's not just an affront to their party, it's an affront to democracy. But as usual, Democrats are do-nothings. They're losers. And by the way, they force us to come out here and tell you the truth. Like, that's what we do. And they think, oh, God damn it, you're supposed to do marketing. You're not supposed to do the truth. Well, we are. They're losers. You have to get rid of their leadership, who are totally and utterly corrupt. Otherwise, they're paid to lose, and they're going to lose to Republicans for the rest of their lives.
One other thing I wanted to mention in this poll, nearly 3/4 of Americans, 74%, say that they're dissatisfied with the direction of the country, including 50% who go a little extra. They say that they're very dissatisfied. So at least half the country is extremely dissatisfied, but the vast majority, 74%, are pretty satisfied, dissatisfied. And again, that goes back to the point that I was going to make, or I've been making on this show and in the context of this story. When you have both parties beholden to corporate interests, there are too many similarities between them, right? And they're not going to actually better the lives of their own constituents, of their own base. And that's the problem that we're seeing right now. Also, a slight majority of Americans in the poll, 52%, say that the Democratic Party has moved too far left, while just 35% believe that the GOP has moved too far to the right. Look, they didn't get into an explanation as to why the respondents feel that way, but I think that the media messaging here is actually quite powerful, because most of the attention in terms of the Democrats going too far left is in regard to, like, the woke stuff, right? And I actually cringe using the word woke, because it's now become like this conservative talking point. But you get what I'm saying. Like, there's constant discussion about cancel culture, which we've talked about in the past. The majority of Americans, whether you're talking about Democrats or Republicans, they think that cancel culture has gone too far. Like, when they think about Democrats, when they think about the left, that's what they think about. They're not thinking about the economic policies, because Democrats haven't delivered on that front.
And it also goes to the propaganda that's blasted out 24/7 by corporate media. The most corporate Democrat in the country, Terry McAuliffe, got his ass handed to him in Virginia. And everyone on cable news, literally, Anderson Cooper led the charge by saying that the Democrats had gone too far left, even though the guy's not left wing at all, not 1%. Okay. And so they repeat it 1,000 times until, hey, and then they ask it in a poll. Now, remember what we told you over and over and over again on CNN, New York Times, and every other piece of trash media that's just marketing for the corporate wing. So too far left, right? Now, is it too far left? They go, oh, yeah, Democrats are too far left. And the Democrats, of course, since they're part of this kabuki theater and their role is to get their ass handed to them by the Globetrotters, they're the Washington Generals, they go out there and go, I guess we're too far left. They send out their own representatives to say they're too far left. And then, of course, since everyone seems to agree, that's what the American people say. It's not based on the issues. I can show you the polling, and we show it to you every day. The country is actually very progressive based on the polling. We want paid family leave. We want higher minimum wage. We want universal health care. But we get tricked by media, Republicans and Democrats, into voting against it.